Good morning, students. Here we will be discussing some of the question answers of chapter 4, Absorption by Roots, the processes involved of biology for standard 10 students. So we'll start with name the following. First one, the condition of a cell placed in hypotonic solution, turgidity, the process by which intact plant lose water in the form of droplets from the leaf margins, guttation, the process by which water enters in root hairs, osmosis, the tissue concerned with upward conduction of water in plant xylem, the term for the inward movement of solvent molecules through the plasma membrane of a cell, endosmosis, the process by which molecules distribute themselves evenly with the space they occupy, diffusion, the pressure which is responsible for the movement of water molecules across the cortical cells of the root, root pressure. So next to this, we will be discussing the differentiate between the following, all the differences, okay. First one is plasmolysis and deplasmolysis. Plasmolysis, it takes place when a cell is kept in hypertonic solution. Then deplasmolysis, it takes place when a plasmolyzed cell is placed in hypotonic solution. Second point, shrinkage of protoplasm takes place. In deplasmolysis, swelling of protoplasm takes place. Plasmolysis, third point, cells become flaccid. Then here, cells become turgid. The next one, turgid pressure and wall pressure, the definition itself. Turgid pressure, the pressure of the cell contents on the cell wall is called turgid pressure. Wall pressure, the pressure exerted by the cell wall on the cell content is called wall pressure. Only one point you got right, okay. Next one, guttation and bleeding. Guttation, loss of water as water droplets from the margins of the leaves is called guttation. Bleeding, loss of cell sap from the cut stem or any injured part of the plant. Guttation takes place through the special structures called Haida throats. Bleeding takes place through any cut or injured parts of the plant. The next one, turgidity and flaccidity. Turgidity, the condition of a cell in which it is fully distended and cannot accommodate any more water is called turgidity. Flaccidity, the condition of a cell in which the cell content is shrunken and the cell is no more tight is called flaccidity. Second point, turgidity, it occurs when a cell is placed in hypotonic solution. Flaccidity, it occurs when a cell is placed in hypertonic solution. Again, now we will be doing the give reasons questions, okay. All the five. So let us start with the first one. First one, if you sprinkle some common salt on grass growing on a lawn, it is killed at that spot. So what is the reason? Answer, sprinkling of salt results the surrounding soil water to become hypertonic. So exosmosis takes place from the cells of the grass, which leads to the death of the plant. Next one, if you uproot a plant from the soil, its leaves soon wilt. Answer, when we uproot the plant, absorption and conduction of water are stopped. From plant, evaporative loss of water takes place and the cells become flaccid, which in turn results the wilting of leaves. The next one, it is better to transplant seedlings in a flower bed in the evening and not in the morning. Answer, because as transpiration increases during morning hours, rate of transpiration, because as temperature increases during morning hours, rate of transpiration also increases, which may hamper the growth of the seedling. The next one, a plant cell when kept in a hypertonic solution, salt solution, for about 30 minutes turns flaccid. The answer is the surrounding solution is hypertonic. So water molecules move out of the cell to the surrounding. That is, exosmosis takes place, which causes the cell to turn flaccid. Then the next question. Potato cubes, when placed in water, become firm and increase in size. Reason. Because the surrounding medium is of water, that is, it acts as hypotonic solution. So endosmosis takes place, which results the potato cubes to become firm and increase in size. The reason is endosmosis. Okay. So next to that, we will be doing some structured or application skill type question. The first one, this is the diagram. So based on this, the question. What is the state of the cell shown in the diagram? So what is the state? It is the flaccid state or plasmolyzed, you can write. Then name the structure which acts as a selectively permeable membrane. Here, what is acting as a selectively permeable membrane? It is cell membrane, or it is also known as plasma membrane. If the cell had been placed in distilled water instead of strong sugar solution, which feature would not have been seen? That is, shrinkage of protoplasm. Name any one feature of this plant cell which is not present in animal cell. That is, here we can see the cell wall. So the answer is presence of cell wall. Next one, a leaf cell of a water plant was placed in a liquid other than pond water. After some time, it assumed a shape as shown below. So based on this, the questions. Give the term for the state of the cell it has acquired, that is, flaccid or plasmolyzed. Then comment on the nature or tonicity of the liquid surrounding the cell. It is hypertonic. Redraw in space here, provided the diagram of the cell, if it is soon placed in ordinary water for some time. So figure 4.9, that is C figure of your textbook, you can. So for that, this diagram, figure 4.9, C diagram, fully turgid cell, you have to draw there. Okay. So next experimental setup is this one, that is of thistle funnel. Study the same and answer the question that follows. First one, name the process. What is the process here? Osmosis. Then define the above named process. You have to define. That one you can get from the textbook. Write the definition of osmosis. The next one, what would you observe in the experimental setup after an hour or so? The answer, what will be? A rise in the level of sugar solution in the thistle funnel. The next one, what control experiment can be set up for the comparison? Same setup, experiment, same experimental setup with plain water in both the both in beaker and thistle funnel. So that is a control experiment. Then keeping within the root hair cell and the surrounding, name the parts that correspond to concentrated sugar solution in comparison with the root hair cell. It is the concentrated sugar solution of, that is, of cell sap of the root hair. Then parchment paper will be of cell membrane. Water in the beaker will be of the soil water. Okay. Then name any other substance that can be used instead of parchment paper in the above experiment. Any other semi-permeable membrane like cellophane paper, egg membrane, animal bladder, etc. Then mention two advantages of the processes of this to the plant. First one example, sorry, the advantages of it helps in absorption of water from the soil by the root hair. Absorption of water from the soil by root hair is one significance or advantage. Another one, to provide turgidity to the cell. So another one is to provide turgidity to the cells. So these are the two advantages of osmosis to the plant. The next one diagram. Next diagram is a root hair cell. Study this one and name the or answer the following question. First one, name the parts labeled A, B, C and D. A is of what? Cell wall. B cell membrane, C cytoplasm and D nucleus. Okay. So next question, the root hair cell is in a turgid state. Name and explain the process that caused this state. Answer. The root hair cell is in turgid state because of osmosis. Because the surrounding soil water is hypotonic as compared to the cell sap of root hair cell. So endosmosis takes place and the root hair cell become turgid. Then mention two differences between the A and B marked. A is a cell wall, B is a cell membrane. One difference is A cell wall is freely permeable whereas cell membrane is semi-permeable. Then the draw the diagram when draw the root hair cell. If the draw a diagram of the above root hair cell as it would appear when a concentrated solution of fertilizer is added near to it, then what will happen? It become flaccid. So the flaccid condition of the root hair cell. You have to label the parts also. Withdrawal of the cell membrane from the cell wall you have to show. Then shrinkage of protoplasm or cytoplasm you have to show. This is the diagram which shows the flaccid root hair cell after adding fertilizer nearer to that root hair cell. Okay, so rest of the question and all you have to do as homework. You try to find out the answers. Okay, thank you.